examples, we're going to fill in the missing coordinates for each of the points. In number 6, we have a square, and it is POST. And right here, it tells us that T is at A0. So I'm going to, over here, put the point A0. Well, what that means is that the distance from P to T is A, and because this is a square, we know all sides are congruent. So we know that the distance for each of these sides of the square is equal to A. P is at the origin, so therefore P is the point 0, 0. O is straight up on the y-axis, so we know that the x value is 0, and because it is a distance of A, that would be at 0A. And then point S is going over A units and up A units, so that's going to be the point AA, and we already knew what point T was. In this example, we have square play, P-L-A-Y, and they tell us that Y is a point of negative B, 0. Well, what that tells us is that the going from 0, 0, since we're going to the left, that's what makes it negative, but it tells us that, this distance is a distance of B, which means that this distance is B. So if we add those two B's together to get this whole length, that means that the length of each side of the square is going to be equal to 2B. And so we know that, from A to L is 2B, and from Y to P is 2B. So to fill out the rest of these ordered pairs, let's start with A, and we know that we're going from 0, 0, we're moving over B units, and we're still on the x-axis, so that has to be the point B, 0. Next, I will go to L, and you don't have to do this in any particular order. If I want to figure out point L, I know that I'm from 0, 0, I'm moving over to the right B, and then I'm going up 2B, and so that would be the point B, 2B. And then lastly, to get the point P, this one you're going to the left of 0, 0, and so that's going to be a negative B, but you're again going up 2B, so negative B, 2B. Here we have square math, and this time they tell us the ordered pair for H, and it is negative C, C. Well, what that means is from 0, 0, when we go out to here, it is a distance of C, and when we go up from here to here, it is a distance of C. So if you use that to kind of help you figure out these other ordered pairs, if I'm trying to find the point for M, I know that from 0, 0 out to the right also has to be C, so that's going to be over C units and up C units, because this is equal to this. We then have point A. Well, point A, you're going over to the right C, so that's a positive C, but then you're going down, and so that would be a negative C. And then lastly, for point T, you're going to the left and down, so that makes both of them negative, negative C, negative C. This last problem changes to a rhombus, so the last few problems have been squares. This one's a rhombus. We have the rhombus band, B-A-N-D, and they tell us a couple of things here. They tell us that the point B is 0C. Now what that tells us is that from 0, 0, when we go up to B, that's a length of C units. And they also tell us point D over here is the ordered pair E0. And what that tells us is that from 0, 0 to here is a length of E. So we can figure out the other two points using this information. What we know is that from D out to here has to be the same amount of units as it was from 0, 0 to D. So this is going to be E. And then the same thing here. When we go past B up to where A would be, on the y-axis, that has to be another length of C units. So the point A you're going to the right E and then up a total of C plus C. So the ordered pair for A would have to be E and then 2C, because from here to here is C, and then you're going another length of C. For point N, you're not stopping at D, you're going past D. So that's going to be E plus E, which is 2E, and then you're going up to the same location as B was, and so you're going up C units. So that ordered pair would be 2EC.